Metro Pacific Investments Corporation eyeing to expand its business in various industries this year. MPIC Chairman and CEO Manny Pangilinan says they are looking at possible expansion in areas like agriculture, tollways, tourism, energy, health, and mining. Though the group is not yet looking at the Sangley Airport project in Cavite, Pangilinan says it could be a potential investment.
I'm personally interested in, because I think it's a good collateral project for NAIA, because I think the runway is capable of being fixed and expanded, and it's a parallel runway to NAIA, and in the long run it could be a replacement airport for NAIA.
Back in 2019, MPIC also expressed interest in the Sangley Airport project, a planned upgrade of Sangley by a consortium of a Chinese company and Lushotan's Macro Asia was scrapped last year by the Cavite provincial government. The Cavite LGU said it canceled its award for the planned $10 billion airport since the consortium wasn't fully committed to the project. The Philippine government now preparing the implementing rules and regulations for the law rendering all birth, death, and marriage certificates valid for life. Warrende Guzman has that story.
The bill declaring all birth, death, and marriage certificates as valid for life has lapsed into law, and the Philippine Statistics Authority is now busy preparing the implementing rules and regulations to make sure all government and private institutions and establishments start accepting submitted copies of these papers for any documentary requirements.
Gagawan po to ng IRR, no? Kasi bagong batas. So sa ngayon, ang panawagan po ng PSA, no? Hindi po kami nagsiset ng expiration or validity sa lahat ng dokumento na i-issue namin. Isang kopya ng birth, marriage, and death, nagcha-charge po tayo ng 155 per copy. And of course, malaking bagay po yan, no, kung naisabatas na po ito, yung permanent validity, mas stronger or stricter yung implementation po natin, malaking tulong po ito sa ating mga kababayan. So, for example na lang po, nung pag nag-apply ka ng trabaho, yung nagre-require sila ng, may alam ako na yan siya, nagre-require ng 10 copies ng birth certificate. So, every year yan. So, malaking bagay po yan.
PSA Assistant National Statistician Mariza Grande adds, it will soon be very easy to validate submitted documents.
Nag-launch na po kami ng bagong issuance ng security paper na may QR code. At malalaman mo kung yung dokumento na isinubmit sa iyo ng isang Filipino or individual ay valid or authentic, no? So, nandun po sa aming website yung PSA e-verification app. Nasa pilot stage po kami ngayon, but within this year po ay mag-roll out na po natin ito sa ating mga outlet.
Certificates printed on the new security paper are now available at the PSA East Avenue office in Quezon City and at other select pilot sites including Olongapo, Iligan, Puerto Princesa, and Valenzuela City. Citizens lining up for their PSA certificates think these latest developments will be great for them and for overseas Filipinos.
Nakakatulong din po yun para po hindi na po pabalik-balik, tsaka hindi na po papaulit-ulit po pagkuha.
Pabor po kaming ganun. Makakatipid po. Mm-mm.
Para hindi na po hassle, lalo na sa may mga trabaho na papunta pa ng PSA para lang kumuha ulit ng mga documents na katulad ng birth certificate.
The PSA notes there are exemptions to the rule. Embassies, for instance, can still exercise their own discretion in deciding which documents can be submitted for visa applications and other similar transactions. Certificates with incorrect or outdated information must also be replaced, such as marriage certificates for unions which have been annulled. More information is available on the PSA website at psa.gov.ph. Warren De Guzman, ABS-CBN News.